years ago, we first featured master storyteller Lopaka Kapanui, who talked about his personal encounters with the spirit world. Since then, his tour business has expanded and added new chicken skin experiences for the month of October. Here's our trusty guide to the dark side to tell you more.
Aloha, my name is Lopaka Kapanui, and I'm the owner of Mysteries of Hawaii and Chicken Skin. And I take people around the island late at night to the most haunted places they've ever visited in their life. It's a great job to take people to these places, educate them, and scare the living daylights out of them. What we have planned for October that's significantly different from all of the tours I've ever done in these almost 20 years is that we can't reveal the places we're going to go to, because the owners of those locations were afraid that the word might get out that their place of establishment is haunted. We're allowed to go there, but we're not allowed to say anything about it, where the location is, and how long we're going to stay. Our regular chicken skin tours usually take place in downtown Honolulu as the old Ghost of Honolulu walking tour. We have a tour that goes out to the Pali and haunted areas in that place. But the most active tour I have, the chicken skin tour, is the tour out to Waianae. For some reason, when we take haunted tours out to this side of the island, especially in the location where I'm standing at now, things start to happen. And I don't make them happen. The people who come on my tours make it happen, because some of them are so sensitive that whatever residual energy is in the environment begins to openly communicate to them. And what I mean by that is, it wants to talk to them, it wants to feel them, and sometimes, if a person is that sensitive, it wants to follow them home. We're in the location of Makua Valley, and where I'm standing at now is called Kanyana Cave. Legend says that this is the cave of a shark god, who was the son of Kamuhuali, the most sacred brother of the goddess Pele, and the king of sharks. Long story short, his father was afraid that his son, being half human and half shark, would begin to develop an appetite for a different kind of flesh. And he cautioned the boy's mother never to feed him any type of meat. But of course, as custom went in the old days, when a boy became 7 years old, he became a man, he ate in the men's house, and his grandfather begins to feed him meat. And so he develops a taste for a different kind of flesh. Fast forward, the early 1900s, travelers happening by this cave late at night see a fire back there being tended by an old wrinkled Hawaiian man. He sees them and invites them in. Hui, hele mai. He's got a long stick with meat sizzling on it over the fire. He gives them their fill. They become lethargic. He changes into a shark and kills them, doesn't eat them. He drags their body to the top of that boulder there and leaves it to rot for 3 weeks, and waits until the flesh is most delectable, and then consumes them. Today, in this cave, there are so many things that have happened here that those tragic events have embedded themselves like an imprint, a fingerprint within the walls of this sanctuary, so people think. And so one night, I bring a group of doctors, of all things, into this cave. And to make it fun, they all want to wear black. We're at the bottom of the cave. We're talking about the hauntings that have taken place. And as we're leaving, I'm the last one to leave. I sort of glance behind me, and I see what I think is one of the shorter guys on the tour, dressed in black. But somebody taps me on the shoulder from behind, and it's that guy. He says, hey, let's go. It's time to go. And I looked at him, and I said, weren't you just over there? He said, there's no one over there. When I turned around, it was the small, shadowy figure of a child. It started to follow us out of the cave. Luckily, I had a bag of Hawaiian salt from the island of Kauai with me. I sort of sprinkled it across the ground in a line, and the shadow stopped right in that spot. You see, there are the ghosts of children in this cave who were killed here. Their ghosts are stuck, and they want to move to the other side. And they're very sensitive to human beings who like children. When they sense that kind of person, they lash themselves onto them and have a tendency to follow them home.
We have more stops on our chicken skin tour, so don't change that channel.